So you want to start killing big bucks, like 150 plus, but you don't know where to look. Well, sit tight, in this video we'll go over exactly where you should start looking, so that you can get on a big one this year.
You rolling? We're rolling.
What do you mean if I touched it?
Smack your mama. No offense, Lord.
What's going on?
Higher. Now it's too high. Welcome to another episode of Creakings, where today we're going to be talking you through how to get on 150-inch deer. You can do it.
Disclaimer. This is for the major Midwest states where big deer are common.
You know, Iowa, Ohio, Michigan for sure.
Illinois, Indiana, Missouri, Kansas, Wisconsin, Minnesota. All those Midwest states where big deer are around. We're going to show you exactly how to find them and the tactics that we use to do it.
It's not as hard as you think, okay? So
I'm going to stop the video right here for a second just to clarify, because I can smell the comments from here. I said it is not as hard as you think to find a 150-plus inch deer. I said nothing about killing one. Now, this video is designed to help you find one, but what you do once you find them, now that part's up to you. Carry on.
Step one. Dude, you know this TikTok song? Step one.
Dreams come true.
Step one. I'm gonna play some.
I must be old.
Make you fall in love with me. One, you're like a dream come true. Two, just wanna be with you. Three, girl, it's plain to see.
Okay, so you wanna find a 150-inch deer. Here's what we got. Yes, it's possible to stumble across a 150-inch deer. It happens all the time. But if you want to increase your chances, you gotta know where to look. We like to call these areas sweet spots. Big deer need three major things to get there: a plentiful, sufficient, secluded food source, a decent bedding area, and water. Now, if you can find all three of these elements in a close proximity, you just found a sweet spot.
Step one for finding these big deer:
e-scout.
What is e-scouting? Basically, e-scouting is getting on your mapping choice. You have Onyx, Spartan Forge, Hunt Stand. We use Google Earth a lot of the times because you can see a lot on there. We use that on Spartan Forge a ton. But get on there, you need to look for three key things. You need to look for: one is their food, two is their bedding, and three, a natural water source.
If you can find those three elements pretty close by, it's what we like to call a sweet spot. And essentially, they do exist. Okay, they do exist, and once you find it, you'll know, okay?
Oh, you'll know.
You'll know, because there will be deer everywhere, okay? You will be able to pull up pretty much at any point in the day, and there will be deer in the field or around. And 9 times out of 10, there's going to be a bigger buck around the area, but they might not show up till obviously later. If you want to see more about how to scout a sweet spot, we made a video about that, link right here. Make sure to watch that at the end of this video.
Now, when you're e-scouting, you need to be aware that the pictures that you're seeing on Google Earth or maybe some hunting application might not be up to date. Those fields that you think you see, I would drive by it in person and make sure that that actually is a bean field or actually is a food source that you thought it was, because if it's not, you're going to have to move on to the next sweet spot that you e-scouted.
So once you have found on your maps what you think is a good bedding area, a good, you know, food source like ag and water, the next step would be, you know, getting permission and just kind of walking that area. Like, it might look good on a map, but it's not going to look good in person. There's no way to tell if it's a good bedding area until you actually go there. Like, the picture could be outdated, or, you know, it could look really thick, but it turns out it's just pine trees, you know, and it looks thick from above, but once you get there, it's like actually pretty open. There's just no way of knowing until you get there.
Make sure to check out the water source. Make sure that it's not going to dry up. If it's a creek bed or a stream that just seems to dry up sometimes, it's not going to be as reliable as a natural water source that will be there all year round. You know? Also, some things to keep an eye out for are primary scrapes, maybe rubs, depending on what time of the year that you're scouting, and look for trails. Just look for buck sign, buck activity, just to let you know that you're in the right spot. And if you can get permission to be on the property, definitely glass over that food source. If it's an ag field, sit on the edge of it, get some binoculars, and just see what comes out. That's going to be your easiest way of telling what bucks are in the area. This is a cool summertime trick that if you're not doing, you need to be doing. It will take your game to the next level. You will get on bigger bucks if you do it enough. We just made a video about this. Make sure to check it out at the end of this video.
I would say once you do that, step three would just be hanging cameras. Don't be afraid to hang a ton of cameras if it's a new area. Like, we literally spend the majority of our week going around and just moving cameras around because we thought that it was a sweet spot and it really wasn't.
Because kind of at this point, what makes us different than what we normally do is right now we kind of know or have a pretty good idea of what they're going to be when it comes season. So these are the kind of deer that you can figure out whether or not it's a deer you want to target or a deer you want to hold off for another year.
So I would say after you hang cameras and stuff, that's like the biggest part. Like, yeah, we just covered that pretty quickly, but that's the hardest part.
Actually, the hardest part is finding the sweet spot. You might not have a nick for it, but all you need is a couple of those sweet spots. If you have two or three, depending on what your target is, obviously this video is made to hopefully help you find 150 inch deer. In those Midwest states, if you have two or three of those good properties, there's a good chance that there's gonna be at least 150 inch deer show up on one of them.
It all starts with finding a sweet spot. You can find it, you can do it. Today we're gonna walk around and just kind of show you some of our sweet spots and kind of show you the deer trails through there and where we set up our cameras and stuff, so. I mean, that's freaking tall as balls.
So what we mean with a bedding area is stuff like this, where it's just thick, nasty, stuff that you don't wanna walk through.
I mean, you literally, quite literally, I can see beds in there. You just can't get through there. Definitely a good spot. Nice.
We got all these apples. Be right here in a little bit.
It's a good way to get parasites.
This is the bean field that they literally tear up every single year. It's been beans for the last 3 or 4 years, not really sure why, but there, as you can see, way over there, it turns into corn. So we've got a good mix of corn and soybeans, so.
Another big thing that where they're bedding at right now, they're bedding in that corn because of, as you can see, it's probably 7 or 8 foot tall. Mm-hmm. So they have all the cover they want and they can walk straight into the bean field.
Okay, so we've arrived to what we call the entrance and exit. Whenever we're talking about the farm, this is what we're talking about, because there's food here, there's bedding in the back with the corn, but also the water's this way. So they literally come in and out.
Oh my gosh.
Like, believe it or not, we don't drive this. This is all deer made. Like, the amount of deer that funnel in and out of here is ridiculous. It's a pinch point without needing to be. There's no reason for it to be, but they just really like it. So there's scrapes and rubs all along this tree line pretty much every fall. So yeah, the water's this way, and basically what we have is a camera set up literally right there, and it's facing this way. We get tons of pictures every single day, all throughout the day, mostly in the evenings and a little bit in the mornings. There's so many bucks.
I know. So
this is where all of the trails pretty much lead. There's like 30, 40 trails that lead to this creek. So it's kind of super hard to hunt like a specific spot. I know a lot of people do deer management where they just make like watering holes. Obviously you can't outwater a creek. So we definitely use this and utilize this for sure. We find a pinch point from a trail between water, food, you hang a camera, you get good pics, you pattern a deer, you put a stand up and you kill them. Yeah, this is a water source. Also, we jumped off that one time. It was fun.
Bro, these bugs are crazy. Oh my gosh. I'm getting molested. I'm gonna need to file a police report after this.
So this is an example of a sweet spot that we have found. If you look on Google Earth, there's a bunch of bean fields and it's sandwiched in between two cornfields. And it's just on like a back road here, but beyond those woods, which is where they're bedding, and in these two cornfields, there's I think it's a creek, right? It's a creek, not a river. It's a creek, and it's like
on the other side of the creek is also more bedding and ag, so it's like a really good spot, we think. So, but before we go and waste our time and ask him for permission, park on the side of the road and glass it. So that's what we're doing today. We've been here a couple times. We've seen a couple big deer, but nothing that was really sparking our interest. So that's the other thing too. If you want to get on a 150-inch deer, you also have to know where not to look. It might be a sweet spot. Just keep tabs on it. Drive by, glass some bean fields. We have a video about exactly what to do and how to find big bucks while glassing as well. So that's what we're going to be doing today. If we see anything cool, we'll put it in the video. But for the most part, it's a lot of nice, cool, easy nights just chilling and glassing.
All right, guys, we hope that everything we talked about today helped you get on at least whatever your target is this year, whatever you want to go after. We hope that this video helped you better understand and possibly go to locate those deer. If you guys have any questions, as always, join our Discord, link in bio. We're growing at a rapid rate. We're almost at 100 members right now. It's a ton of fun, ton of chaos, a lot of hunting stories, a lot of pictures, and it's just a good old time. So if you guys haven't already, make sure you join that link below.
What's cool about the Discord is if you're trying to get on a 150-inch deer and you live in the states that we previously mentioned, we can help you get on a deer because we're active in that community. We talk every night. We have these meetings where we literally live chat. We put our cameras on and we just sit there and talk with you guys. That's the time to present your questions. You can share your screen and show us, you know, your specific hunting piece, and we can kind of help you piece together a good spot to sit. If you have any questions, we're by no means any experts, but it's cool when you get a bunch of the guys who actually do know a lot. You can tend to, you know,
pick up a lot of information.
Exactly. So join the Discord, link in the description. We are doing a huge giveaway, a new Prime inline. Once we reach 10K subs, which we're pretty close, we've already gained 1,000 last month. We're getting there soon, okay? Link in the description for the video to click on that will explain everything. It takes 3 seconds. All you have to do is like, comment, and subscribe to this specific video.
Chance at a custom $1,200 bow for free, nothing other than subscribing.
Exactly. So why not have a new bow going into the season? Peace out.
Peace out.
I love you guys.
Kind of.
What are you doing? Did I scare you?
Yeah.
Let me see that pee.
You made me pee myself.
Did you? Did you pee on your hand?